rest of neurons that lie along the margins of the lateral ventricle, and it is due to arrested radial neuronal migration. The occurrence usually is sporadic. However, there are some cases that are familial, and it is, has an X-linked pattern of inheritance. What we have to check is if this nodule has appearance of gray matter in all sequences, just to prove to ourselves that it is a heterotopia and not an other abnormal subependymal nodule. It can be one and can be multiple, as in this case. The nodular subependymal heterotopia can be multiple, outlining the lateral outline of the lateral ventricle on both sides. In this case, there's also a heterotopic gray matter focus here. The ectopic neuron rest may occur all along the way from the periventricular white matter to the cortex. So they can arrest all along the way as a linear gray matter, as in this case. However, sometimes they actually look like a mess. This ectopic gray matter even causes a mass effect on the ventricle and the folds. And again, what we have is to prove to ourselves that this is gray matter in all sequences. Another example for focus subcortical heterotopia is this case with a very thick gray matter and blurring of the gray-white matter differentiation. The band heterotopia is actually the neurons started to do the migration towards the cortex and stopped as a band in the middle. So we have alternating gray matter, white matter, gray matter, white matter, and again the cortex gray matter. So all these band of gray heterotopic gray matter is the band heterotopia. It is called also the double cortex, cortex sign. Okay, seen here on T1 imaging and lissencephaly is a smooth brain, right? The ciliary fissures are often shallow and widened and vertically oriented and extend to the vertex. There will be dilatation of the ventricular system. The cortex is consists of four abnormal layers instead of the normal six layers that we know. Several genes that cause various forms of lissencephaly, such as ARX and DCX. These kids present with developmental delays, seizures, poor feeding, tonus and movement disorders, and dysmorphism. The classical of 8, seen here in an ultrasound, all we see is just the ciliary fissure and no other suicide or gyri. In CT, in the Miller-Dieker syndrome, again, figure of 8 brain, and we can see that the cortex is definitely abnormal, even though this is just a CT. On MR, very flat, of smooth outline of the brain tissue, and on coronal imaging, the figure of 8. If we look closely into the cortex, we see that there are arrested neuron layer, which is very thick, and there is a very thin cell sparse one here on G2, the hyper intense, and then a thin cortex on top of it. So this is the hallmark of lissencephaly, and we have to look for it in all imaging. Pachygyria and simplified gyral pattern are less severe forms of decreased gyration, sharing common etiologies and symptoms as lissencephaly. So we see small and less gyri than we should have seen. In this case, it's almost lissencephaly. Polymicrogyria is many small excessive gyration accompanied with microscopic abnormal cortical structures, and it presents with developmental delay and seizures. It may be focal, can be diffuse, and it can be one-sided or both sides, symmetrical, asymmetrical, and most commonly seen in the pericilium region. It looks like a toothbrush or a small villi. And in this case, it's only in the frontal region, seen nicely here on the coronal imaging, but it can be diffused, as in this case. Every single one of them is a tiny, tiny gyri with, again, another HR topic, gray matter. Sometimes it's not easy to appreciate that because it looks like a very thick gray matter, thick cortex, but if we look closely into it, we'll see that it is composed of many small gyria. Can be perisylvia. In these cases of perisylvia polymicrogyria, we see that the sylvian fissures are abnormally placed. They are posterior and vertically oriented, and this is outlined by small polymicron gyria. Another case of perisylvian polymicrogyria, again, widening, it's not in an abnormal position of the sylvian fissure, and it is outlined with small polymicrogyria. Schizencephaly is a cleft line with heterotopic gray matter that extends from the ependymion of the lateral ventricle to the pial surface of the cortex. It may result of a genetic mutation or secondary to destruction of immature brain prior to neuronal migration. It can be uni or bilateral, closed or open lip, and it is classically located in the distribution of the middle cerebral artery. There is association with heterotopias and polymicrogyria. In this case, it's an open lip, both sides, larger on the right side, smaller on the left. On pathology, we see that it is outlined with gray matter on both sides of the cleft. It can be seen on ultrasound imaging. Here, a cleft leading from the ventricular wall to the large open lip schizencephaly. When it is a closed lip, we have to look for signs because sometimes we can see it and sometimes we just have clues. So, one of the clues that we have to look for is the ventricular nipple. Outpouching from the lateral aspect of the lateral ventricle leads towards the cleft. Sometimes the cleft is closed. And then if we see closely, we see that it is outlined on both sides with gray matter, which is, of course, easier if the cleft is open, okay? Seen on CT and on MR. And again, gray matter on both sides. Commissural abnormalities, well, the most common one that we all know is a genesis of the corpus callosum. 4% of all CNS malformations and 50 to 80% have other malformations. Outcome can be from good to poor, depends, and the associations are various, just listing few of them, PRE2, Dandy Walker, malformation of cortical development, and 200 syndrome have reported callosal degenesis. The signs are absence of the corpus callosum and cingulate sulcus, the radial arrangement of the medial cerebral sulci around the roof of the third ventricle. This is also called the sunshine sign. This is the mesa intermedia, the sun, and the rays are the sulci diving into and towards the mesa intermedia. Seen on ultrasound as well, the mesa intermedia and the sulci. There is no corpus callosum or cingulate gyrus in the midline. Off-midline imaging, sagittal imaging, will show us the hypercephalus and mainly colpocephaly. On axial imaging, the colpocephaly, which is a sign for a genesis of corpus callosum. And the lateral ventricles are parallel. This is also called like the motor rally car, race car. This is for you. So this is a typical sign for genesis of, yeah, you can choose now. On coronal images, there is upward elevation of the third ventricle with the frontal horns pointing laterally. This is caused by the bundle of probes that can't move from one side to the other, the corpus callosum, so they are stuck here in the middle and they push laterally the frontal horns. This is called Salvador Dali mustache or chandelier sign. Well, we have to have imagination, right? DTI, well, we can do this nice images today and see the parallel fibers of the chromosome dumpers from one side to the other, and the bundle of probes that swirl in the frontal region. We all remember that the corpus callosum is formed from anterior to posterior, rostrum, gene, body, and splenium, and we can have partial agenesis of corpus callosum. Usually it will be absent parts of the splenium and rostrum that form later on. And we have to check if we have agenesis of corpus callosum for other malformations. So in this case, we have a large interhemispheric cyst and polymicrogyra. And this one, well, this was a disaster. There's absence corpus callosum, okay? There is subependymal nodular heterotopia. There is a heterotopic a gray matter in the frontal region, like a delination ring. And we have also polymicrogyra seen here in the frontal region. So very complex malformation. Lipoma of corpus callosum is a misnomer, commonly located within or replaces the genome of the corpus callosum. And since it is fat content, it would be hyperechoic and ultrasound, fat content in CT, and we can measure it, and T1, hyperintense, okay, and then fat suppressed. We did all what we could to prove that it is fat. It actually acts like a mass, however, it doesn't cause any mass effect. Here, an example of lipoma of corpus callosum with fat suppression, and we see this kinetic small, what is left of the corpus callosum. So what we see the mass, however, it doesn't cause any mass effect on the vessels. Here, the circle of Willis, unaffected.